Stream a live sports event today. Stream thousands of live and on-demand sporting events from any device. Click link in description box down below to watch full game in high quality. Don't forget to like and subscribe this channel for more sports updates. Thanks for watching and enjoy the game.
I'm riding high, there's a reason why a bluebird is singing to me. A friendly air is everywhere, and everyone I see has a gay.
Hello!
For they seem to know a bluebird is singing to me. Hi-ho, hi-ho, the sun's in the sky, my cares seem to fly, how lucky am I. And if perchance some new romance should join my symphony, if he comes along, I will thank the song a bluebird is singing to me. La 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 la. If I'm riding high, there's a reason why. Friendly air is everywhere, and everyone I see
gay.
Hello, for they seem to know. I hope, sun's in the sky, my cap seem to fly. How lucky am I? And if perchance a new romance should join my symphony, if he comes along, I will thank the song of bluebird is singing.
Don't forget to stop for the beer. Oh, Pop, it skinned me alive if I did. I buttered the inside of the pail so old man Schultz couldn't put too much of a head on the surf. He always gives you more bubbles than beer. Pat, can you move the piano?
Oh, sure.
I'm giving a party tonight, and I've simply got to have that piano moved.
Well, I guess we'll have to do it the same old way.
In the stove and close the damper.
What? Again in the saloon?
Well, I've got to get that piano moved, and I don't know any better way. Here, use these.
Who's the party for, Lulu?
Billy.
Charles Billingsworth, is he coming here?
He certainly is. He promised to see all my protégés, and I particularly want you to look your very best now, Patricia.
Oh, golly, Lulu, I will. Here they come.
Oh, your father's taking a whole minute off his usual time.
Oh, but he better not find me here.
Let's skip up the back stairs. Hurry.
No. Hold everything. Hold everything. Hold everything. Open the windows.
Why, Matthew, whatever are you doing here?
What am I doing here? You know very well what I'm doing here. This is the third time in a month you're turning a false alarm in Amilulu. And I won't have it. I won't have it.
Matthew, I don't know what you mean.
Are you plotting against me? Ruining my record of efficiency so that Olsen and his Scandinavians will make a laughing stock of me?
Oh, now, isn't that awful? Somebody must have turned in an alarm just because Tony was burning old rags in the stove.
Yes, and I know who that somebody was.
Oh, what a shame to get you all out and on a Sunday, too. Oh, that's terrible. It always makes you so cross. But you know, Matt, even if you are no grouch, I'm glad you're here.
Yeah?
Of course I am.
Why?
Because I want to invite you to the party. You and Clancy and all the boys are off duty.
What party?
The party, the one I'm giving tonight. And especially for you, Matt, I'm going to have corned beef and cabbage.
Oh, that's fine. That's grand.
Matt, now that you are here, would you have your boys put my piano up there on the platform?
I knew it. I knew it. You shameless, scheming woman. You turn in a false alarm to get your piano moved.
Oh, but it's such a little teeny piano, Matt.
Do you think New York created a fire department to be messenger boys at your beck and call?
Oh, Matt, how can you talk like that to me?
Oh, don't cry, Lulu, don't cry. Take it easy, take it easy. Well, what are you standing around like ninnies for? You heard what he said? Move all the tables and chairs and get the piano up there. Let's get out of here before the chief comes.
Oh, thank you, Matt.
Hello, Pop.
Oh, is there a fire?
As if you didn't know. And what's the party for?
Oh, it's very special. Charles Dillingsworth is coming down here to look over my talented fledglings.
Dillingsworth? The stuff shirt.
Now, you be nice to him, Matt. He's a very important man in the theater, and these young people need his help.
Help? Why, he can't even help himself. Him and his pills. And don't you let me catch you thinking theatrical thoughts, young lady.
Oh, no, Pop, not me.
See you tonight at the party.
here indeed. Let's send potato sacks to the time he pulls a keg of beer. Good afternoon, Chief.
Hello, O'Neill. Fire out already?
Everything's under control, sir.
Fast work. This will bring Company 24's efficiency record right up to scratch.
What do you mean, Chief?
Why, you were trailing Olsen's company. This will put both of you in a tie. Good work.
Olsen, that's Scandinavian.
Well, we did it.
Oh, my gosh.
What?
Pop's lunch. I forgot to give it to him.
Oh, don't forget your dose art lesson at 2.
I won't, Lulu.
Pop, wait! Hey, Pop!
Oh! Well, what a pretty picture. I wish I'd painted it that way.
You're not hurt, are you?
Of all the stupid elephants I've ever seen, you two take the cake. Why can't you look where you're going?
Well, we were looking where we were going. We're just trying to find
I thought so. A couple of hayseeds from New Rochelle.
No, we're not. We're from Boston.
Hicks.
Hicks.
Look at me. Just look at me.
We are looking at you.
Look at my hat. You mucked me all up.
I wouldn't say that.
Look at my hair. Look what you've done to it. It's
like spun gold.
My dress is all dirty.
It's more charming than the latest Parisian frocks.
And that's not all. Just...
Your eyes? Even angry, they put the stars to shame.
Oh, let her go, Steve. I'll go in and see if this is Lulu Varden's.
How did you hear about Lulu Varden way up in Boston?
Indians. They spread it by Tom-Tom. They sent up smoke signals from hill to hill.
Oh, so you're Indian.
Madam, you are at the moment conversing with Maestro Johnny Bennett, the great young composer.
And with Mr. Stephen Davis of Chestnut Hill, the great young artist.
How do you do? I never heard of you.
Well, nobody ever heard of us.
Ah, but they will. Our fame will spread throughout the land. We'll take New York by storm.
We'll take London.
We'll take Paris.
I'll take a ride.
It's a nice neighborhood.
I think I'm going to like it.
Professor Garibaldi wrote that you boys were coming. He said some very nice things about your music, Mr. Bennett.
Your ears must have burned from the nice things he said about you.
Oh, bless his heart. He's such a darling. You know, he used to occupy about the very same studio I reserved for you. Are you a composer too, Mr. Davis?
Me? I'm too weak to carry a tune.
Oh.
Now, Steve's an artist.
Good. This studio has a fine north light, just right for an artist.
Well, that's peachy, Mrs. Barton.
Everyone calls me Lulu.
Everyone calls me Steve.
I'm Johnny.
Oh, I'm very happy to know you both. The price will be $6 a week, double. Pay your own gas and no cooking.
Here's a month in advance.
I'll pay you back, Steve, as soon as I sell my first song.
What kind of a struggling artist are you?
Well, he's a different kind, ma'am. You see, he's struggling not to be a banker.
Oh.
You see, Lulu, my old man is the head of one of the oldest banking houses in Boston. He sort of planned on having me follow in his footsteps.
But you always wanted to be an artist, eh?
Well, not exactly, but it was one way of getting to Greenwich Village to have fun.
Lulu.
Oh, yes, hello, Peter.
Well, here's a couple of dollars on account. I played at a dance last night.
Oh, Peter, look at those cuffs. How do you expect to get jobs that way? Here, take this money and go buy yourself a new shirt.
Well, thanks, Lulu.
Oh, Edgar, how did the audition for the symphony go?
They turned me down.
Oh, now where are you going?
Oh, I'm not skipping, Lulu. I was going to... It's a wonderful violin. Worth money.
Mm-hmm. I thought I saw that pawn shop gleam in your eye. Don't be silly. Go back to your room. How are you going to audition without it?
I told you the audition was...
I mean the next audition, the one when they won't turn you down.
Oh, thanks, Lulu.
Say, what kind of a landlady are you, anyhow?
What do you mean?
Well, you're supposed to harangue and berate and foreclose mortgages.
Even cast people out in the snow.
Oh, next week, East Lynn. No, boys, this is a house of artists. Some are singers, some are writers, and some are painters. But all are artists. I was one myself.
A great one.
And so you see, without art, we have nothing to live by. People pay when they can, and if they can't, well, they're still artists. And I still love them.
Lulu, you are a very nice girl. Will you marry me?
I think I'm a little old for a June bride. Ask me next January. Well, here we are. I had your things brought up just as soon as they arrived by express, and your trunks are in the bedroom.
Thanks.
And here's the piano. Oh, I do hope it's in tune. Well, I'll leave you boys to get settled now. The laundry's picked up on Tuesdays, and the gas meter's just outside the door when the lights go out.
When you leave, the lights will go out.
Well, then just drop a quarter in the meter. Come right this way, and I'll show you how. Put your coin in there. Now, that'll give you one revolution. Oh, by the way, Steve.
Yes?
A young lady telephoned you, a Miss Radford. She wants you to call just as soon as you arrive.
Her number's on the telephone pad downstairs.
Well, thanks, Lulu.
You don't waste much time, do you?
Oh, life's too short to waste time. Keep beautiful.
Steve, is Livy here in town?
Staying at her aunt's.
Say, that's swell.
Yeah? What's swell about it?
Well, you're in love with her, aren't you? She's your fiancée.
Oh, sure, sure. Now, don't get me wrong. Olivia's a great girl, and she'll be a wonderful wife. But this isn't Boston. This is Gotham, served up on the half-shell at Reisenweber's. This is the land of wild oats and Greenwich Village and beautiful women. And I don't want any Boston strings tying me down.
Hello, Pat.
Hello, am I late?
You better not let your father catch you.
Very well, young lady, let us begin. Now, we will start with the hand positions in the middle zone. Number one, the palm supine. Number two, the palm prone. Number three, the palm vertical. Tessie, dear, the palm vertical should be raised in gentle terror. Remember as you move into the mood that you're with a cad. A cad? A nefarious scoundrel whose intentions are not honorable.
I'm sure Byron's intentions are honorable, Lulu.
Who?
She means Byron Jones. He's always making the palm vertical to me.
But suppose Byron weren't out with you?
I'd just like to see him out with anyone else. We're practically engaged.
Does he know it? Come, come, come now, girls. Come, let's try it again. Patricia, Patricia. Now, how many times have I told you? You should be weak and wilting and timid, as if the very air around you were charged with peril.
But that's namby-pamby, Lulu. I'm not afraid of anything.
My dear, do you wish to be a star? A great star? Or do you wish to dispute the championship with Mr. James J. Jeffries? Now, that's more like a lady.
A lady?
Patricia, life is a book of etiquette and rules. You're born a girl, but you have to learn to be a lady. Girls may be attractive to boys, but only ladies attract gentlemen, and only gentlemen are rich. You know those two new boys that are staying with me?
Uh-huh.
Suppose one of them were a millionaire. Suppose one of them were a Boston banker incognito.
Oh, then he'd be in Boston being a banker.
Oh, no, you're wrong. He might be right here, learning to paint or compose. As a matter of fact, my dear, he is right here.
Swell light on this end. How about you?
Fine. This window looks out on somebody's roof terrace.
This one looks up at heaven. Hey, take it easy. You could pickle onions on that kind of music.
I can't seem to get this tune. It's a nice quiet place.
Retreat keeps the palms vertical. Fear, 2, 3, 4. Delight express it with the face. Joy give to the whole world. Grief, 2, 3, 4.
Hey, Steve, come and take a look at this. It's a little goat we locked horns with.
Was original.
Yeah, so did I.
Hey, you.
Who, me?
I want to see you.
You do?
Right away.
Oh, I'll be right over.
Hiya. Hey, who are you? What's your name?
I'm Byron Jones.
Byron?
Yeah, I'm a poet.
You're a card.
No, a bard. I'm one of the bards of Greg's greeting cards. I write verses for birthdays and Christmas and all that. You know, like, roses are red, I send them to you just to say on this day, I'll always be true.
Look, I'm Johnny Bennett. This
Hiya,
is Steve
Johnny.
Davis.
Hello,
Hi.
Steve.
Look, where'd you hear my tune before?
Oh, I never heard it before.
Well, but you sang words to it.
I made them up.
Just like that?
Sure. I can write poems faster than you can write music.
You can, huh?
Huh?
Well, we'll see about that.
Okay.
Now we'll see how good you are.
June moon.
June.
Intelligent.
Oh, not only that, but I'm smart, too. I'm the only guy in the world that can rhyme orange.
Orange?
Yeah.
Orange. Hey, that is a tough one. How do you rhyme orange?
Oh, no, you don't. If I told you, I wouldn't be the only guy in the world anymore.
Look, I'm writing tunes and I need words. What do you say we team up, Byron?
Leave us get working and keep the muse perking. I'll bet that's Eddie.
Come in.
Hi, Eddie. Come on in. Hey, fellas, this is Eddie Gaskin.
How are you?
I'll bet Lulu sent you up here to invite the fellas to that shindig tonight down in the restaurant.
Do you usually ride that nag around the third floor?
Oh, that's just a model. He's an artist. He lives right across the hall.
An artist, hey? You sell your stuff?
He sure does. He's got pictures all over the country in all the best places.
Where?
He's hanging in every pool room, saloon, livery stable.
All the best places.
They are for his pictures.
What kind of pictures do you do?
He does calendars.
Ah, girls.
No, cows.
Just cows?
That's all, just cows. Contented cows, discontented cows. Blue cows, moo cows. He's the bovine Botticelli.
Well, how'd you happen to pick on cows?
He's a little cow happy. He painted a picture of Pat O'Neill once. Boy, was she mad.
What happened?
Well, nothing much, really. She turned out kind of pretty, except for the horns.
Well, you're in a bad way.
He can't look a bottle of milk in the face anymore. They're trying to graduate him to horses.
Calendars. Seems like a good way to break in. Might try it myself.
Just go see Mr. Ward. He's the president of Calendars Incorporated. Maybe he'll give you a job.
But I don't know him.
Oh. Well, he does. He'll take you down tomorrow and introduce you.
Thanks, Eddie. You're a thoroughbred.
Don't forget to call Olivia.
I'll pay her a quick visit on the telephone, and then we'll settle down to a life of art. And things.
Hello?
Hello, Libby. How are you, darling?
I'm just fine, darling.
How long are you going to be in New York?
Don't sound so worried. I'm going back to Boston tonight.
Oh. Well, that's too bad. Doesn't give me any time to see you.
You can see me, Steve, night and day for the rest of your life simply by going back to Boston with me to a wedding.
Oh, but I can't, darling. You know I want to, but I've got to have a try at my art.
Don't play Rembrandt with me, Steve.
Rembrandt?
We've been through this artist thing before. You had to go to Paris, remember?
When the girls caught on to you there, you had to go to London. When the ladies there got your number, you came running back to Boston.
Oh, really, Livy, that's not fair.
It certainly isn't. And now it's Greenwich Village. Well, this is the last time you're going to break out the plow to sow your wild oats.
I'll be patient for 3 weeks. No more. Paint fast, young man.
But 3 weeks is all I'll need.
3 weeks is all you'll get. Then back to Boston to be a banker and a husband. Shall we have tea?
Well, I'm pretty busy.
Oh, if you'd rather not.
Oh, sure, sure, Livy. I'll meet you for tea. 4 o'clock at Rector's?
4 o'clock.
You're the most wonderful girl I've ever known.
I'd rather be the only one. Goodbye.
Women. That's what I said. Women.
Try this. In her bonnet of blue, what a picture she'd make. No. Try this. In her bonnet of blue, what a picture she made. She was the belle of the Bucket Brigade.
Come in.
hiya, Pat. This is Johnny Bennett, Patricia O'Neill. We just call her Pat.
We've already met, in a way.
Lulu set up some tea for you.
Oh, boy!
Not for you, Byron. This is strictly a Boston tea party.
Oh, I can take a hint. A house doesn't have to fall on me.
Well, a house will if you don't hurry. Tassie's waiting for you downstairs.
Oh.
Where's, you know, the other one?
Steve? He's not back yet.
Oh.
Well, you don't have to look so disappointed.
I'm not. I didn't mean that.
Then you'll have tea with me.
I'd love to. How do you like your tea?
Lemon and one sugar. And I saw you dance down there on the roof. You were pretty good.
Thank you.
You were really wonderful. Only I can't say things like that. Makes me blush. I'm a shy guy. Where'd you learn to dance like that?
Oh, it was easy to dance to the music you were playing. What was it?
One of my tunes.
It's beautiful.
You know, it was a song I could never finish. I was stuck with it until I saw you start to dance, and then it would just kind of flowed out like champagne.
You're about as shy as a brass band.
Well, don't get me wrong. I really am. Well, what I mean is I...
What you mean is you like me.
Well, that doesn't sound strong enough, but on account of I'm shy, I'll settle for it. Anyway, thanks a lot.
What for?
Well, for letting me in your life, for being here, part of Greenwich Village in New York.
What I can't figure out is how you can like leaving a palatial mansion in Boston and coming to a grubby place like Greenwich Village.
Wait a second, I think you've got something wrong. I haven't any palatial mansion in Boston. I haven't got but a dollar to my name.
Then it's Mr. Davis.
Oh, Steve. Yeah, he's quite wealthy. Banking family. He's very sophisticated. Been to Europe, London, Paris.
Oh, don't you worry. Someday when you've written your songs, you'll be rich, too.
Well, I'm not worried. I don't even care.
You don't care?
No.
Don't you want to be rich and famous?
Well, if it goes with being happy. You see, all my life, ever since I was a kid, I've been full of music. Before I even knew what to do about it, I had songs in my head. I used to hear them playing at night with full orchestra when I'd go to sleep. And even then, with a kazoo or an ocarina, when I was old enough, well, I'd play these tunes out until my mother didn't know what to do with me. Now this is wonderful. Piano like this, to play to my heart's content. To write out some of these melodies that have been inside me. I can sit here and touch these ivory keys. Look up at the stars at night through this window. And they'll become my orchestra, playing with me. With all the strings and horns and harps of heaven, joined in a strange and wonderful symphony.
That's beautiful, Mr. Bennett.
You're beautiful, Pat.
Thank you.
Call me Johnny.
I was just going to.
You know what's happened to me since I saw you?
What?
Pulse fast, lump in the throat, hot and cold flashes.
Maybe you've got the measles.
Yeah, and maybe I've...
Yes.
Say, I've got to write a jingle for the party tonight. Byron left these lyrics here. Will you help me with it?
Sure I will. We've got to impress Dilly. I met an old flame at the fireman's ball. How does it go?
Well, that's what I want to know. How's this?
That's good. Do it again.
An old flame at the fireman's ball. She was so charming, so dainty and small. By the old hook and ladder, she hooked me right in. I felt her mischief begin. When she gave me the eye, how the sparks began to fly. Now my heart is on fire when she's in my arms. I can hear nothing but fire alarms. And it's thrilling to think she was willing to fall that night at the fireman's ball. In her bonnet of blue, what a picture she made. She was the belle of the bucket brigade, and she looked so demure by the old fire hose. I simply had to propose. How my heart seemed to pound as I waltzed her round and round. By the fifth time I kissed her, I heard people call,
why don't you two go and hire a
left for Niagara that very same night after the fireman's ball.
In his bright red suspenders, he said, "Oh, you kid, what did I do? Well, you know what I did. I fell hook, line, and sinker for that so-and-so. How was a young girl to know? Oh, I thought he was true blue with his 23 skidoo. He gave me the hot foot and I should have learned. I played with fire and boy, I got burned. But if you want the truth, on my knees I would crawl back to the fireman's ball."
There was Patsy,
O'Leary,
O'Toole,
Hopchurch,
all of them trying to win her away, but those visiting firemen hadn't a chance. She never gave him a glance. She had eyes just for me, just the way it ought to be.
So the Murphys and Hannigans caused quite a stir.
All the shenanigans didn't face her.
For 'twas I who walked off with the bell of the brawl
down at the fireman's ball.
Never ever would have happened if she hadn't happened to be standing there. She was such a lovely creature, I could be just such a lovely love affair.
Then the band began to play the melody. I said, "Would you consent to dance with me?"
She was all a twitter, but she didn't disagree.
How my heart seemed to pound as I walked her round and round.
Then I slipped a ring upon her finger and we went to linger underneath the moon. I could see that we were heading for an early wedding in the month of June. Soon we'll have a lot of little blazes. We'll be singing praises as we bring them all
back to the fireman's ball. Back to the fireman's ball. Back to the fireman's ball.
Very good, Lulu. Very good indeed.
Tell you I had some interesting proteges?
That one there, the one with the little blue hat.
Patricia, you mean?
She's very attractive. I'll have to keep my eyes on her.
You'd better keep your eyes off her, or else I'll knock them out of their sockets.
And what business is it of yours, may I ask?
That Colleen happens to be my daughter. That's what business it is. And if I catch you filling her foolish head with foolish notions...
Are you implying that I...
No, Dilly. He means the theater.
Well, what's foolish about the theater?
The theater, huh? Well, that's only for show-offs and brazen women. And no decent place for any self-respecting man or woman.
Oh, I'm of the theater, man.
Ah, but you're an exception. But I still say...
Oh, you say? You say? And I suppose it's better for the self-respect to sit around a fire station all day, just waiting for an alarm to ring. Just sitting there hoping that somebody's house will be burned down, and then licking your chops that somebody's going to be toasted rare, medium, or well done.
Hanging man, I save lives.
And we in the theater save souls.
Boys, don't spoil your appetites. Oh, well, the food is coming. And for you, Matt, darling, corned beef and cabbage.
Corned beef and... Oh, my dear, oh, my word, what an awful combination.
Oh, Dilly, darling, try it just once.
I wouldn't mind trying it once, but it keeps repeating itself.
All right, Ben, I'll take over. All right, boys.
Well, how do you like New York?
Not as much as Boston.
Oh, is that so? Well, you have no Statue of Liberty.
No, but we have the Cradle of Liberty, Faneuil Hall.
You have no Palisades.
Bunker Hill.
At Trinity Church.
Old North Church.
Grant's too.
Paul Revere.
You win.
You forgot the one natural beauty that makes Boston a wilderness and New York a shining city.
And what's that?
You.
New York is a nice place to visit.
Yes, it has quite a future, they say.
It's got Fifth Avenue, Mr. Chauncey Depew.
And the street that is known as Broadway.
New York has a glamour.
What is it that makes every stranger so gay?
New York is a nice place to visit.
But it's also a nice place to stay. New York has its own Tony Pastors, where Astors and Vanderbilts call.
It's got Diamond Jim Brady and Rose T. O'Grady. It's even got...
New York is a nice place to visit.
but we say it's a nice place to stay. New York is a nice place to visit, but we say it's a nice place to stay.
Oh, Johnny, I want you to meet Mr. Dillingsworth. Dilly, this is the young man I was telling you about, the one Professor Garibaldi sent down from Boston. Mr. Bennett? Mr. Dillingsworth.
Glad to know you, Miss Bennett.
Glad to know you, sir.
He's a composer, Charles, a pupil of Garibaldi's and very promising. I want you to listen to his tunes.
Young man, it was nice knowing you. Good night.
Oh, he'll listen to your tunes, Johnny.
Really, Lulu?
Tunes, darling. Tunes.
What's wrong with tunes?
They give me dyspepsia.
Babes in Toyland didn't give you dyspepsia.
No, but that was Victor Herbert. His music is immortal.
And profitable.
Mr. Dillingsworth,
hey, young man. Young man, I give you some advice, free.
Yes, sir?
Stop writing tunes. Go back to your first love, driving a beer wagon or bank clerking or whatever it was, and live out your life happily.
And if I don't?
Then poor Dilly will just have to listen to your tunes.
Very well, Mr. Bender. When you have a score, a complete score, I'll do you the honor of listening to it.
And I'll try and give you the pleasure of hearing it, sir.
Now that I've had a sample, how about each and every dance?
Do you always sample everything first?
I'd like to sample Crepe Suzette's with you alone at Maxine's.
You'll be too busy painting.
Well, every artist has to have his inspiration. Da Vinci had his Mona Lisa, Goya his Duchess.
And Whistler had his mother.
Seriously, Pat, you're just the model I want. The moment I saw you dancing on the roof, I knew I had to paint you.
You haven't met my father.
I don't want him to pose.
No, and he doesn't want me to pose. If he heard you asking, he'd knock your block off.
Listen, Pat. Eddie tells me that his calendar company is having a contest. A calendar contest.
Calendars?
Sure, they want something new, something fresh, something different. And there's a $500 prize for the best picture.
500 smackers?
Pose for me, and if I win, it's all yours.
500. Gee, I could get Pat that sterling silver speaking trumpet he's wanted so long.
Then you'll do it?
Uh-huh. But mum's the word. Byron.
Mm-hmm?
If you don't hold me closer, I'll get hoarse shouting all the way over there to you.
Oh, I can hear you fine.
Byron, you're so cold.
I am.
Hold me tighter. Like this.
Please. Not in public, Tessie.
Everybody here got the tickets for the jamboree?
No, what jamboree?
You mean you haven't heard about the Fireman's Benefit Jamboree at the Swiss Gardens the night of June the 30th?
No.
Beer, Dutch lunch, maybe a moonlight stroll with your best girl or somebody else's.
I'll take two.
Two girls?
No, two tickets. How much are they?
A buck each.
Well, I'm a little short. I'll take one now and pick the other one up later.
Sure, sure.
Shall we dance, my dear?
I'm warning you. Keep that silly Dilly away from me, daughter.
Do you want her to be an ignorant Irishman like yourself?
Well, that's better than being no Irishman at all.
Oh, Matt, she needs grooming. You can't grow her up to be a fire chief.
Matt, he's here.
Who's here?
Old Smorgasbord himself. Foreman Olson.
What?
Now, Matt, take it easy.
Olson, you spying snake, what are you doing here?
Good evening, Mr. O'Neill. I just dropped by to wish you...
Wish me bad cess. Well, the same to you. And if you're as good at fighting fires as you are at passing insults, you'd be the battalion chief by now.
Now, O'Neill, just don't get a stroke. Man, your age shouldn't get so excited. You know I cannot be battalion chief until my engine company number 18 win the efficiency trophy.
Oh, get out of here. And stop spying on better engine companies than your own pitiful crew of arseners.
As a matter of fact, if the Yost called me, O'Neill, that you and I may be tied on our efficiency record.
So?
So I thought, if it happened, we might just settle the issue at the Jamboree with a contest.
Contest? Why, I'll wrestle you, I'll fight you, I'll drink you under the table, or anything else you like to name.
A tug of war, maybe?
Tug of war, is it? Well, how can you tug of war at the jamboree?
Why not?
But you mean on the dance floor of the Swiss Gardens?
We used their regulation sneakers.
Oh, sneakers, is it? How did you hear that, man? A tug of war, he says. Agreed, Olson. Agreed. And we'll pull your scrawny little team clean over into the East River.
It's a bargain.
Tug of war. An engine company 24, the champions of the city. When the square hits crazy.
I smell a rat, Matthew.
You do that, but he's not a very smart one.
I'm in love with a calendar girl. Every day of every month of every year.
If you want to buy your dad that silver trumpet, you'd better sit still.
Da 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 dee dee dee, I love you. Have I told you lately I love you?
Beautiful.
Yeah, that'll work.
And beer. Let's have some pretzels and beer. Let's have some pretzels and beer. Strike up the song of good cheer when the glasses are clinking.
What rhymes with clinking?
Winking.
Winking.
When the starlight is winking and clinking and blinking.
There. What do you think of it?
I think it's just beautiful, Steve.
Boy, if it's pretty faces they want in our calendars, that's it.
It's great, Steve. It's great. If I had more time, I'd rave about it. But I got an appointment with Mr. Charles Dillingworth to play my score. For the love of Mike Byron, where's the waltz?
It's underneath your arm. Don't be so nervous.
The more we got to hurry or we'll never make it. Oh, Pat.
Yes, Johnny.
Aren't you going to wish me good luck?
You bet I am.
Oh, I got to get my hat. I'll meet you outside.
This is better than wishing you good luck, Johnny. It's my St. Cecilia medal.
Thanks, Pat. I can't lose now.
Johnny, go on, go on. You're late now.
Well, goodbye, Pat.
Bye, Johnny.
And now, what are you going to give me for good luck?
Golly, Steve, I don't know.
I'll tell you what.
What?
Celebrate the finishing of the picture with me.
When?
Tonight. Reisenweber's. Champagne, caviar, lobster. And you and me.
But tonight's the fireman's jamboree at the Swiss Gardens.
Anybody taking you?
Well, not exactly. I think Johnny said...
Then you're going with me.
Patricia!
Coming, Lulu.
Your father's lunch is ready.
Oh, my gosh, Pop's lunch. I almost forgot. He'll be fit to be tied. Goodbye, Steve.
See you tonight. Oh, Eddie, did you finish the horse? You're in a rut, kid. Come on. Tell me what you think of mine. There you are. Don't like my masterpiece, eh? Old stuff, eh? Nothing unusual, nothing different. To tell you the truth, Eddie, old boy, I haven't quite finished this little job as yet. I still have, shall we say, some unusual touches to put into it. You know what the calendar people said? Something different, something daring, something to make the people's eyes pop. Hi, kid. Did you see Dilly?
Yeah, after a five-hour wait.
How'd it go?
I don't know. Just kept swallowing pills. Didn't say. How about you?
Oh, the calendar's been submitted. It's gone in.
What are you all dressed up for?
Hi, my boy. I'm going out.
Where?
On the town. An hour at the Swiss Gardens, then Claridge's, Churchill's, Sanssouci. I'm going to show her all of them.
Olivia, you mean?
Olivia, I don't mean. I'm presenting Miss Patricia O'Neill to New York in a champagne night to celebrate the finishing of my picture. Who knows what wonderful things may happen?
To Pat or to the picture?
Both. Love to have you along, John Boy, but you know the old adage. Two's company and three isn't even a quartet.
Wait a second.
What?
Steve, I don't like this.
Write a letter to the Times.
Oh, that's not funny. Pat's a nice girl. A very nice girl.
To put it mildly, she's a dish. But she needs to be told about life.
She needs to be told about Olivia.
You better keep your nose out of my business.
Yeah, but Pat is my business. And I don't like you going out with her when you're engaged to Olivia.
Johnny, how could you think? Look, a fella could change his mind.
It would be better if you made up your mind.
You wouldn't be jealous, would you?
You bet I would.
Too bad, too bad. Isn't it a shame that Pat prefers me? You know, I'd make any sacrifice for you, but c'est la vie, c'est la guerre. And now, if you'll excuse me, I'll be wafting along.
Alone? Or may I go with you, Steve?
Libby, I'm glad to see
Hello,
you.
Hello, Johnny. You seem to be happier to see me than Steve is.
I was never so glad to see anybody in my life.
Thank you. I hope I haven't interrupted any important plans, darling.
Who, me? I'm delighted you came, darling. Here I was going out all alone, and you arrived.
Won't you join us, Johnny?
I'd love to.
Oh, no, no. He can't. I mean, he has a date. You're going out with Pat, aren't you, Johnny? Huh? You're going out with Pat to the jamboree.
Oh, Pat. Oh, yeah, we have a date. we're supposed to go to the... I mean, we'll probably go
Isn't it at the Swiss Gardens?
I think that's what she said.
Oh, I almost forgot to give you the $5 I owe you. Well, I'm sure Pat's waiting for you, isn't she, Johnny?
Oh, sure, yeah. I'm sure she's waiting. You'll excuse me, Lydia.
Oh, yes, Johnny.
Have a good time.
We always have a good time. Goodbye, Johnny. Shall we go, Steve? I have my aunt's carriage.
Oh, that's wonderful. Simply wonderful, darling. So good to see you again. And what a surprise. Why didn't you let me know you were coming?
I prefer to steal up on my prey and catch the critter dead to rights.
What do you mean, Libby?
I think you know what I mean. Where are you taking me?
Delmonico's.
I want to be bohemian. Let's go to the place where Johnny's going.
Oh, no. Johnny might be embarrassed.
Johnny or you?
Well, what have I got to do with it?
Who is this girl, Pat?
Patricia O'Neill.
What's she like?
Well, she's not your type, naturally. She's just
an ordinary girl?
Well, yes. She's,
the quiet type?
Not exactly, but,
beautiful?
Oh, not exactly, but,
talented, perhaps?
Not exactly, but,
what does she do?
Well, she's just a girl.
An artist model, maybe.
She has been posing lately.
Not for you, by any chance.
Well, yes.
Oh, I'm most anxious to meet her.
I don't remember where Johnny went. There are 100 beer gardens in New York.
Oh, I do. The Swiss Gardens.
Yeah, sure. Everybody having good time.
There's O'Neill. Better go easy on that beer, O'Neill.
Go away, you little pipsqueak, or I'll drown you this time.
And don't... Oh, good luck.
He's right about that beer, Matt. You may have a tug of war tonight.
I can drink a barrel of beer and still pull the little square head and the whole of his company right off their legs with one hand.
But, Johnny, I still don't understand what happened to Steve.
In a minute, you're going to hurt my feelings.
Oh, that would be very silly of you. I can't think of anyone I'd rather be with than you, but I still don't see why he didn't.
Oh, well, I'm a lucky guy, Pat. You see, a friend blew in from Boston, and Steve had to... Well, you know.
Well, it was very nice of you to take me instead, John.
Oh, I didn't want to. I fought against the whole thing. Steve, I said, now why should I take out the most beautiful, the most wonderful girl in New York when I can stay home alone in the attic and play dominoes? But I finally gave in. Waiter.
Pat! Johnny! Gosh, are you surprised?
Well, for the love of Mike.
Hello, everybody.
Hello.
I would get you. There goes my tips.
So this is where you learn to rhyme beer with tear.
What are you doing here?
Verse has gone from bad to worse.
And so you're a waiter.
Yeah. Tessie's a pretzel girl. Just for a couple of hours at night. Bella has to live, you know. It's not bad. Pay and tips and pig's knuckle thrown in once in a while. Will it be beer?
Yeah, I'll have a beer.
Make mine a ginger beer.
Okay.
But Byron, put it in a real beer stein, huh?
Oh, don't go away. I got a surprise for you. Well, come on, Tessie.
What do you suppose he's up to?
No telling.
Have I told you lately I love you? Have I told you
lately? That's one of your songs.
Byron's not only a waiter, he's a song plugger.
I may be blinded by all of your charm.
For God's sakes, what are you doing here?
Steve!
Hello, Pat.
Olivia Radford, Patricia O'Neill.
How do you do? Hello.
Do you mind if we join you?
Oh, no. Please do.
Yes, please do.
Thank you, Johnny.
Miss Radford is from Boston.
Oh, really? You're sure you don't mind our joining you?
Oh, of course not. We're glad to have you. What a surprise, huh, Pat?
Yes, I should say so. Well, Steve, she's really beautiful. You didn't do her justice. My dear, you've been underestimated. Sometimes I think men don't like women. Maybe I'm not their type. I'm sure you're Steve's type.
Olivia.
Will you have a beer?
I'll have a beer, please. Olivia?
I'll have a ginger beer and a dance with Johnny.
I only handle the refreshment side, lady. You'll have to make the other arrangements yourself.
Come on, Johnny, darling.
Who, me?
Yes, I want to speak to you.
Alone.
Excuse me. Say, what's the idea of nailing me?
Am I that hard to take?
Not at all. Well, you're already taken.
What about that girl, Pat?
Isn't she wonderful?
That's what I'm afraid of.
Remember, Livy used to tell me that someday when the right girl would come along, I'd start sending up skyrockets and get absent-minded.
I remember.
Well, last night, I put out the clock and wound up the cat.
Don't tell me that for once in his life, Steve told the truth.
He said I was stuck on Pat. He sure did.
Oh, Johnny, that's grand. I'm so happy for you. Oh, you don't know how happy it makes me.
Your lady friend from Boston certainly doesn't let any dust settle on her feet.
Oh, Olivia's always rather had her own way.
Is Johnny part of her own way?
I don't know what you mean.
How long has he known her?
Oh, they're old friends.
What kind of friends?
Well, you know.
You men. You needn't cover up for him. Some men just like to play the field.
Oh, now, look here. I didn't say that.
She's very beautiful, isn't she?
Yes. Takes after my mother's side, I'd say.
Your mother's?
Hmm.
Are you related?
Cousins. Oh, but don't mention it. We never talk about it. It's a tiresome idea.
But I thought... Steve, I have a confession to make. I thought you stood me up.
Why, I wouldn't do anything like that to you. I just had to... You know.
Yes, I know. Relatives. It's a lovely night to go dancing. Why waste it?
It's a lovely night for a moonlight stroll. Come on. Well, isn't this much nicer than dancing? Moonlight and the girl you love.
Johnny says you go for the girls, and the girls sure go for you.
All the girls in my life are you, and all nights are tonight.
You kissed the Blarney Stone. But it really is a lovely night.
This was meant to be our night, until it got spoiled. If only Olivia hadn't come.
Johnny was glad enough to see her.
Anyway, you and I will have another lovely night together. Just the two of us, without anyone spoiling it, and only the stars for company.
Please don't.
Pat, this is the only moment of our evening.
Gentlemen,
don't waste it.
I give you the mayor of New York City.
Oh.
Hey, wait a second.
It's the mayor.
Well, what do we care about the mayor?
But it's the duty of every civic-minded citizen to listen to the mayor. Besides, there's an election coming.
But women can't vote.
To be here with you tonight in the intrepid company...
Steve?
Oh, hello, Livy.
I've changed my mind. We're going to Delmonico's.
Oh, but we can't just walk out on the mayor.
He isn't the mayor of Boston. Good night.
Good night, Livy.
Dilemma. The fine records of two fire companies.
There's something wrong. I can feel it in my feet.
Number 24, under Foreman O'Neill. And number 18, under Foreman Olson. Are so matched that we could not pick either one to win the efficiency trophy. So, we shall let Foreman O'Neill and Foreman Olson settle it between themselves by tossing a coin.
Do you have a coin?
Thank you very much. If you gentlemen will step forward, please.
Wait a second, Your Honor. Tossing the coin is not a contest. Just luck.
We've agreed to settle it by tug of war, Your Honor.
Done. Square away your teams.
Oh, yes. My mistake.
All right, coach up, boys.
Good luck, Pop.
You know anybody who wants to bet against your dad?
He loves me. He loves me not. He loves me. He loves me not.
Can't that guy make up his mind?
That's what I want to know. He loves me. He loves me not. He loves me. Oh, Byron, it took you so long to make up your mind.
Hey, take it easy.
When I'm with you, I get feeling all peculiar. My heart starts pounding and my pulse runs wild and my blood runs hot and I get feverish.
Gee, you ought to see a doctor.
And then I start to tingle and I hear bells in my ears.
Fire bells?
Wedding bells for you and for me. Oh, Byron, I thought you'd never ask me.